And the Canes will put total leather to crank us up. And they thought about a return, then thought better of it. They'll bring it out to the 25. On first down, here comes this offense. Out of the chute, quick toss to the right.
I'll tell you, I love the play call on first down here. You're just trying to find an easy completion, and the shortest throw on the field for the quarterback is finding your biggest target, and that's the tight end. Nice job.
Line getting set on second down. From the gun, running back gets the give. Looks as if that'll be enough to give Washington State a first down.
Well, the offense knew what they needed to get that first down, so they dial up the running play, and they get just enough to keep the drive alive.
They've got it at the 37. It's first and 10. Back to throw. It's Milroe. Just too much mustard on that one. Can't miss the target that badly.
Man, as a quarterback, you got to be careful. He's lucky there. If you miss high throwing over the middle of the field, oftentimes that results in interception. So lucky that ball was incomplete.
Now on second down after the incompletion. From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three.
Well, the linebacker's showing you read and react. He knew exactly where that running play was going, and he beat the football to the line of scrimmage and forced the TFL.
They line up with some serious work to do if they want to convert this one. On third and long, hoping to throw beyond the sticks. And the incomplete pass will bring up fourth down.
You got to love that. On defense, one of the most critical statistics out there is how do you play on third down? How do you prevent the opponent from keeping drives alive? Right there, tackling the catch. You gave up the completion. Whoop-de-doo. You set up fourth and long. You're going to get the ball back. Go get some water and celebrate. All right, let's get
it. I like this call in plus territory. The punt would have to be so precise, might as well leave the offense out there on fourth down. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. Got away from trouble and got rid of it. And that one falls incomplete. A huge stand by the defense.
That's a great job there by the defense here early in this game, getting a huge stop, and they've got an opportunity to make the opponent pay. Offense taking over now in great field position. Let's see what they can do here from a play calling standpoint to try to put some points on the board.
Trying to start the drive with a pass. Fires to the big fella. He's brought down. Solid pickup, but a little bit short of the first down. Just a quick rhythm throw there and really good use of the tight end.
Yeah, good use of the big fella. I mean, go through your progressions real quick. You can't find anything. Get the easy gain. Don't take a shot down the field all the time. Take those shots later, but take those easy, wide-open opportunities to get some positive chunks.
Looking downfield, it's Winston. Throws for the tight end. He's got it. Touchdown, Miami. Reeled it in and just made the house call.
And what a nice start for this offense. The throw game getting working, getting the touchdown pass. This quarterback getting a little bit of confidence. This passing game getting in a rhythm. Nice start for this offense.
Getting set for the point after. And he's got the extra point, and it's 7-0 to start this one. This offense prides itself on going after you, and they did with that long touchdown pass to finish off a two-play drive. They're just about ready to kick it away. Fielded in the end zone, it's Lacy. I know he thinks he can house every return, but sometimes you just have to take a knee as he stopped at the 14. Washington State has it back, and they'll send the offense onto the field. We'll see if that failed fourth down in their own end last time, David, sort of curbed some of the aggressiveness.
But you hear about it all the time in football. Go for it. Be aggressive. The problem is, when you get stopped, sometimes it puts you in a hole. And Jesse, now the offense has to come out and respond.
They were real disappointed not getting that first down. You could see it on the sideline. So let's just see if that's kind of galvanized them a little bit here to go make a statement and get some points.
Off play action. Looking left. Makes a connection. They stay aggressive and push their way out to the 33, and it's first down. Sometimes your tight end's a safety valve, and sometimes he's your go-to receiver.
And the offense knew right away he was the primary target. It's where he was going with the football, because you know you get a little bit of suck up from those linebackers with the play action, and you feed the big fella.
To the air. It's Milroe. He's got the back in the middle. And they'll pick up the first down and mark it at the 47.
Well, it's a nice play design there. You're getting the running back involved in the pass game. Quarterback gives it to him early so he can go to work upfield and get the first down.
The Cougars will snap it on first and 10. He's looking to throw it. Quarterback doing what he does best. He can move.
Well, the offense trying to stay aggressive, right? You just came up with a huge play, and right away you go back to another pass. But you got to do a better job protecting your quarterback. Can't give up a sack there.
He's looking to throw. And he was hit just as he released it, and it falls to the turf.
We're already in the first quarter, but already you get the feeling this could be a long day for this QB. He's already been sacked. He gets hit right there on the incomplete throw. They've got to find a way to do a better job up front of protecting this guy, or it's going to be difficult to put up points.
Now he's going to break the pocket. Throws it back across his body, and what do you think happened? Intercepted. A return there would have just been icing on the cake. They'll just have to settle for the cake at the 23.
That's the end of the first quarter. Miami, 7. Washington State, 0.
First down to start the drive after the break. They'll run the RPO and fire to the right. He will step out of bounds, but not before the big pickup and a first down for this offense.
Nice job decision-making by the quarterback there in the RPO, not handing it off, knowing he had to throw it, but then also understanding his open guy was going to be in the right flat.
They gave themselves room to operate with that first play. Now first down from the 37. Wide receiver coming across in motion. With jet sweep pass. He's brought down, but he went backwards after that completion, not the way they had it drawn up.
Well, I love the aggressive nature of the defense on that play. Everybody playing with eye discipline. They saw the pre-snap motion. They knew who had the football, and you saw guys play with excellent instinct, running downhill and making a tackle.
And here comes the offense on second down. Scanning the field, it's Winston. Zings it complete to the right. Open runway ahead. He's at the 10. And he just kept running, and he ran away from the crowd, and he'll take it in. Touchdown, Canes!
Well, in the modern era of college football, you're seeing more and more athletic tight ends. Like what you just saw right there. The defense had no chance covering that guy down the field. He makes them look silly on his way in for the long touchdown.
On to attempt the try. And the extra point makes it 14-0. Quick strike offense on that three-play scoring drive. And they finish the drive with a 64-yard scoring toss. Not going to risk a return here. He'll make the fair catch. First down here with time for maybe one more play until the two-minute warning. A quick pass to the left. He's there to make the stop, but the damage has been done as they pick up the first down on the throwing catch. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. Looking to move it through the air. Working on the right. And perhaps a touchdown-saving tackle as they get him down at the 37.
Wow, they've been waiting for that play, right? They haven't been throwing it a lot. They've been real sluggish. They've got no points on the scoreboard. And now they come up with an explosive play in the passing game to get them in a position to score some points here, hopefully a touchdown, before this first half closes out.
They'll try to kick it into overdrive. Clock's running. Second down coming. Dropping back, it's Milroe. Dances away from the heat. Fires on the move. Got his man downfield.
I love when QBs break the pocket and still look to attack. Because as soon as you break the pocket, I'm thinking, oh man, he's going to take off and run, and I might come up. But those big plays can be made down the field. Nice job by the quarterback keeping his eyes down the field.
Hit hard as he released the ball on that first down pass, and it never had a chance. Second down coming up on this red zone opportunity. Back to the air one more time. And he got smacked just as he released the pass. It's incomplete.
Doesn't take this defense a lot of time to get to the quarterback, man. They've got speed all over the place. They hit him so quickly, and because of that, the ball falls incomplete.
On third and long, trying to have a big completion here.
Tell you what, I don't know if the offense was expecting man coverage that time. Third and long in field goal range, you're expecting it to be zone. Instead, they lock them up man-to-man, everybody on an island, everybody won. They get the incompletion, now setting up fourth.
Here we go. Three straight incompletions, and undaunted, they'll go for it on fourth and 10. Pre-snap motion quarterback trying to get a read. On fourth down, they're taking to the air. He wants it all. And it's incomplete. The long pass downfield they couldn't hook up.
Oh, that stings, man. You did a great job calling the play. You got your guy open. Everything was executed perfectly. And the ball hits him in the hands, and he just can't bring it in. Man, those are tough ones. Those are tough to swallow.
And here comes that Miami offense back onto the field. They've jumped on them, executing at a high level and up 14-0, David.
This is the exact start you want. I mean, offense is playing great. Defense has gotten stops. You're in a position now, Palmer, to put the hammer down and get a three-possession lead.
I'm really impressed with their physicality on both sides of the ball early in this one. They've been winning in the trenches. So here on offense, keep running the football and show your dominance.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and 9. Looking to throw, it's Winston. Quarterback floating away from pressure. It's incomplete. Good job by the defense sticking with its coverage.
It didn't look to me, guys, like the QB and his target were on the same page on that outbreaking route. I'm not sure if they both thought it was man or zone or what was happening, but I think that helped lead to the incompletion.
Quarterback checking the play. Third and long, and he'll try to throw for it. Complete downfield. He'll get it up to about the 32-yard line before he stopped, and it'll be first down.
And listen, the defense knew coming into this one, they were going to target him early and often. He is a weapon, and there's no mystery where the quarterback's going to be looking on critical down and distances. Let's see how they're able to cover him throughout the rest of this game.
Quick timeout call by the offense after the play.
Great job creating space. That's what you're supposed to do. When you get man coverage, you got to find a way to get a step, make it easy for your quarterback to read that leverage, and when he drags across the field, he can see he had him. He completes it for the first down.
Fires to the big fella. turns it on in midfield. He's run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down.
Well, we knew coming into this one, the tight end was a big part of this offense, and you've seen it early in this game. They've moved him around. They've thrown it to him in a lot of different ways. Defense is going to have to make some adjustments trying to stop this guy.
And the Canes come to the line with a new set of downs. He's going to pass. A little too much on that one, just out of his reach.
I love the decision by the quarterback. He found the open man, just don't love the throw. Got to be a little bit more accurate, make it easier on your target.
And here comes play number 6 of the drive. Wants to throw. It's Winston. Fires to the wideout. It's caught downfield. Touchdown, Hurricanes! That is the ultimate grab and go for the score.
One of the reasons this offense is so exciting to watch, they've got guys that are dangerous after the catch. And if this quarterback gets through his progression, David, hits you in stride, these guys will take it to the house.
Man, it's your job to do the rest, right? You hit me in stride where I don't have to stop running, I don't have to break down. It makes it so easy, the connection between quarterback, wide receiver. You can tell this is a good one, and that's why they got 6 on that play.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And with the extra point, they're up 21-0. So a drive there of 85 yards. And the finisher coming on that 42-yard touchdown toss. Fielded in the end zone. It's Lacy rolling the dice.
To the 13.
The end zone did not work out as he stopped at the 13. Ready? Running out of time here in the first half. They're going to have to be efficient to put some points on the board before the break. They needed to find enough space and get it moving forward. And
all right, just leave. See you later.
A timeout is called as this offense tries to find a way to get more points on the board before the half. One more snap coming before halftime. Give to the running back. At the 35, he's open. And you make the stop, and that is the end of the first half. Washington State ready to boot it away to start the third quarter. Fair catch called for and made. Up, David. The offense has really been moving the football.
And it's been great execution.
And they get to the quarterback and knock him down back at the 16.
And it's such an advantage for this defense to have an outside linebacker like that that can rush the passer, because they can set the edge. They can get off the ball, and they're just way too fast for tight ends or for offensive tackles to get out and block them.
To the tight end, and that defense doesn't allow a cutback, and they get him out of bounds after a short gain.
Nice route there by the tight end, making it real easy for his quarterback to find an easy completion.
This defense has kept them backed up. Now one more stop and they can get off the field on third and long. Receivers telling the quarterback what they see. On third and long, he'll have to turn it loose deep. Catch in the middle, it's Belly. He'll have enough to move the chains. It's first down at the 38.
Man, I just love how tight ends are used nowadays. They don't just line them up on the line anymore and say, go play ball. Move him all over the field. He can catch the football. He's a matchup nightmare. Continue to exploit him, continue to move him around. That's why that dude has over 150 yards receiving on the day.
Motion by the back forces the defense to adjust. All kinds of room to the right. He's at the 30. Seizing that open space and opportunity all the way inside the red zone. They'll mark it at the 19.
How many ways can I get it to my guys who can fly, who are playmakers, and let them make big plays? This is another one you've seen. Catch the football, flip it ahead really quickly, get it to a burner, going full speed across the formation. He gets the edge, makes the big play.
Wide receiver shows motion. To the ground with the back. Not much working there. It'll be second and 9.
Brought down. Near the 18-yard line. Second down coming up.
Went with the running game on first down, now back at it. Dropping back, it's Winston. Unloads to the wideout. Got it!
Well, that's another completion. This quarterback's on fire. I get it. He's thrown for over 200 yards in this game, but it's because he's got people helping him out. How about that incredible job diving out, stretching out, and hauling that pass in? Quarterbacks love it when they don't have to be perfect every time they throw the football. And this group of receivers, they are helping out their QB1.
That's the end of the third quarter. With the score, Miami 21, Washington State 0.
They'll try to open this quarter by sticking it in the end zone here. They'll run it. Touchdown, Miami! And the pummeling has started. Precision blocking up front created the open lane, and the running back followed it beautifully.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to follow an offensive line that makes those holes and just gives you a caravan all the way to the end zone. What an unbelievable job blocking up front.
Lining up to add another.
The kicker is on for the extra point.
The kick is up and good, and put one more on the lead. An 84-yard drive there, and close the deal with a 3-yard touchdown run.
Washington State, 0.
The kickoff team takes the field to boot this one away. Here comes the Wazoo offense onto the field again. Going up top on first down. And the ball comes out. What a disaster.